Hello Capricorns, welcome to my channel Surabhi, and this is the reading for you and your person. On one side will be your energies, on other side will be the energies of the person you are dealing with, and then the most likely outcome. So let's see what we have for Capricorns. Okay, Five of Pentacles on your side. The Hangman on your person side, and the likely outcome is the Ten of Swords. Okay, so you feel ignored, rejected, left out in the cold, and your person with the Hangman, no action. This person is not making a move, this person is not taking any action, and that is the reason perhaps that you are feeling left out in the cold, you feel ignored, you feel avoided, and the outcome is the Ten of Swords. Obviously you feel very hurt, betrayed, and you feel as if you just can't take it anymore, you're done with it. Let's see what we have as the clarifiers for the Five of Pentacles. Okay, Page of Wands, the Hierophant, the Two of Pentacles, the Two of Cups. Okay, what is this Hangman here for? The Ten of Swords, again, Ten of Swords, Ten of Swords, Page of Cups, King of Swords, the Magician. What is this? Why is Ten of Swords here for? The Queen of Cups, the Knight of Cups, the Nine of Pentacles. What's wrong here? The Devil, the Tower, Ace of Cups. What's going in this reading? See, for the Five of Pentacles, we have the Page of Wands, the Hierophant, the Two of Pentacles, and the Two of Cups. What I see here is that you started off beautifully in this relationship, and there was a commitment also. Started beautifully with all the spunk and the vitality, zeal, and with a commitment in mind. Perhaps you were actually committed to each other, because we have the Two of Cups also. So definitely a very passionate connection over here, a very deep connection over here, which is a very vibrant and lovely connection, started off beautifully, but with the Two of Pentacles, there is something which is bringing the indecisiveness over here. There is some sort of indecisiveness, inability to make up your mind. Something is going on over here. And perhaps this indecisiveness is the reason that you feel bad about. Let's see how the reading proceeds. I'll take more cards if I need to. Okay, and over here with the Hangman, we have the Ten of Swords, the Page of Cups, the King of Swords, and the Magician. See, what I am getting here is that perhaps this person is not making a move, or things are on hold for some reason, and what I feel is that this person is coming out of, see, what I am getting here is that this person perhaps was very playful or very light-hearted sort of a person initially. But then circumstances in this person's life were such that this person had to undergo a lot of struggle for some reason. Okay. So there is, as this person aged, as this person grew with age, there are very lot of hardships which are associated with the life of this person, and this person has had a tough time liberating him from those tensions and those hardships. And with the Magician, they have really had a hard time in life to unburden themselves from the hardships and weave a new beginning of their life, or to write a new beginning of their life. So this person has a rough past. They've had a hard time coming out of it and live a own life which is better. And perhaps that is the reason that this person doesn't want to commit, perhaps, or doesn't want to open up, whatever reason, doesn't want to move forward. Can be the reason. And since this indecisiveness is there, perhaps on their part, that no action is being taken, you really don't know what's going on at their end, and that is why you feel hurt and ignored. Though the connection is deep, at least from your side, I don't see anything like that much on their side though. Honestly. Perhaps you view this person as your soulmate, or you are, from your heart, you are committed to this person, but I don't see anything like that from this person's side. They are still in that own shell. They have really worked hard to come out of the negativities and liberate themselves or unburden themselves from whatever the tough life they had, and that is why not making any move. But I really don't see any love over there much on their side. Let's see how it is. The outcome is a Ten of Swords. Obviously, a lot of pain, a lot of agony. For the Ten of Swords, we have the Queen of Cups, the King of Cups, then the Nine of Pentacles, the Devil, the tower and the ace of cups. So what I feel is that even if there are a lot of emotions, there may be emotions, but they are not surfacing. But what I'm getting here is that you have a lot of emotion. This person knows that perhaps. They're watching that undercurrent of emotions. But you are also sort of now done with it. Excuse me. You are also done with it, though you have a lot of emotions. But what I see is you are done with it or not, I am not very sure. But yes, you have a lot of emotions. This person is watching those undercurrents of emotions, but they're still not doing much about it. And here with the Nine of Pentacles, you are the Devil, the Tower, and the Ace of Cups. What I feel here is with the Devil and the Tower, the major arcanas again, there is something. I see here you focusing on yourself with the Nine of Pentacles. Something unexpected comes in. See, it can be one more thing. As the outcome, since the other person knows your emotions, perhaps you can expect, at least some of you, a sudden opening up from that person's side, or sudden new beginning from, which is unexpected basically, from that person's side. Maybe they open up for some of you, but for most of you, what I am getting here is that you are, since things are just not working out, it comes as a unexpected shake-up for you. Then you just start focusing on yourself perhaps, and then with the Ace of Cups here, what I see is you're guarding your heart and moving on. So perhaps since you viewed this person as a soulmate or your passionate partner, you wanted to have a committed relationship with this person and nothing really happened, it came as an unexpected shock for you. But ultimately, you've started focusing on yourself and moving on, guarding your heart towards a new beginning. Let's see what is the guidance from the universe for you. Embrace your emotions. Number 18 or number 9 may be of some significance for you today. Today I'm filming this on 18th. Maybe today's day is important for you. Embrace your emotions. Allow your feelings to surface and be accepted. So this is obviously, you have to embrace your emotions. I think it goes more for the person you're dealing with. They need to embrace their emotions. And perhaps, as I said, for some of you, there may be unexpected opening of the heart from their side. Maybe they embrace their emotions since they are watching you. They know that you have a lot of emotions for them. But for some of you, it may be that you have to understand that this won't be working and you need to accept that and move on, guarding your heart. So it will be different for different people. Just take it as it resonates with you. So that's all I have for you, Capricorns. And please subscribe to my channel. Let's meet in the next video. Bye.